is with the utmost pride and sincerity that I present this recording as a living testament and recollection of history in the making during our generation.
Allow me to reintroduce myself. My name is...
Allowing us to film here. So, hi Todd.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Excellent. If you don't mind just introducing yourself to our readers, please.
Hi, I'm Todd Kempton, and I'm a hair colorist at Anthony Cristiano.
Excellent. And if you can just tell us a little bit about what you do or your background, how you got into this profession.
Hair was never my first goal. It was fashion school. So I went to fashion school first and never finished. And then on the help of a friend told me to go to, they should go to beauty school because I always did hair like for fun. And so I went to beauty school and I think that the fashion background helped merge with the hair, the creativity and everything. And I picked color, I think, because color comes so naturally after being in art school, like knowing the color wheel and everything inside and out.
Right, excellent. And so you do that here now at
Nicholson? Yes.
Excellent. And do you want to talk about the salon a bit?
Well, the salon is a brand new space located on the mezzanine level of the Trump Hotel Chicago. It's all like the brand is all about fusing fashion, luxury into like a non-pretentious environment. Like everyone's like a friend and family, but they feel at ease. Like I had someone the other day just ask me, do you have a no cell phone rule? And I said, absolutely not, but and no one feels like they need to be on it because they just enjoy their time and their space.
Excellent. I love it here. And
it's very ethereal. Like you walk in and it looks relaxing.
Glamorous, but it's very homey.
Exactly. Like you're a big hug.
Exactly.
A big hug from everyone. Yeah.
Wait. We're going to laugh the whole time.
We can laugh the whole time.
So we'll talk about how I met Todd. I met Todd. I was covering an event. Honoring Mamie Walton, and I spotted this guy with like the coolest, I was like, man, that's so fresh. He had on these jackets with this epaulette that were just out of this world, amazing, and I said, I had to take a picture of him. So I literally just went up and I go, oh my God, I want a picture of you, and I did, and then we started talking, and he's just been awesome ever since. So, but now Todd's gonna tell us exactly how that jacket and the epaulette came to be.
One of my friends is a big collector of Jean-Paul Gaultier, and he always gives me pieces from the collection that he feels like he's reached a point in his life that he doesn't want to wear them anymore, like he's too old, I guess. And so he gives them to me. You're never too old for fashion, right? That's a good tagline. And he gave them to me, and I just actually attached them to, it was like a Zara jacket.
They looked fabulous.
They changed everything, right?
Yes. Yeah. Yes. And then, Todd, so I came here to cover the launch party, Anthony Cristiano launch party. And here we are, and he told me, like, prior to these, he goes, I'm going to blow you away. And I was like, he goes, it's an ode to Isabella Blow. And I go, I cannot wait to see this. And so we walk in, and of course, the first thing literally we see is a hat.
A giant bird.
It was a bird. I was like, what is going on? And so it was Todd wearing the Anna, what were you wearing?
It's Anna Della Rosa for H&M. She's the editor at large for Japanese Vogue.
Perfect.
She did a collection for H&M. And I think I'm the only one that bought that hat, but
I don't think so.
It's amazing.
He bought the Fascinator hat with the bird. And yeah, and Todd is just, I don't know, he's perfection. All in one, awesome. So now, and so we're going to talk about some fun facts, Todd.
Okay.
About you. You can give us 3, you can give us 5.
30.
Or 30.
30.
Yeah. So let's go through some fun facts.
Fun fact. What did I tell you earlier? That my life revolves around work, fashion in The Real Housewives.
Real Housewives of
everything. All of them.
Oh, really?
Every single one.
Who's your favorite character?
Lisa Vanderpump.
Really? Have you seen her new with the new show?
Vanderpump Rules.
Yeah. The sexy restaurant.
Sir, where you take your mistress. Yeah. Yeah, but she's better on The Housewives,
really?
I feel.
Lisa, if you could raid Lisa Vanderpump's closet for three things, what would it be?
I don't even know. Have you seen her closet?
They should
I would just want her closet. I would just want to live in there for an hour. Like, just be there. Like, you could coexist in that space.
That's awesome.
That's my goal, I think, is a Real Housewife-style closet.
Let's find a Real Housewife-style husband.
Yes, and then I can have the closet of my dreams.
So
the
Todd,
salon.
Yes, if you can just tell us a bit more about the salon and also about you specifically, you know, your colorist here. What are some color trends that you're looking for now? Like, we're not really having an average Chicago winter, or maybe someone looking for a change of pace into the spring. We're in the new year now. People are probably looking for a new look or to something to spice up.
I think what, like, trends in hair to me are not always something you should, like, look for.
Right.
You should do what feels natural and what looks the best on you.
Okay.
I think so much we get caught up in, like, we see celebrity and we see what trends are and this and that. But there's also, when you see a magazine or a celebrity, you know, that's 2 hours of hair and makeup to get them to look like that with a team of people. So the average person, that's next to impossible to obtain at home. But I feel like when it comes to, like, your color and your cut and your style, you should keep it, like, as true to yourself and to your hair, you know, as possible. So your color shouldn't be so far from the natural realm of your color. I like to say, like, you know, amp up what you already have. You know, make your hair look as beautiful as you feel.
Okay.
Like that. I think that's a better thing than a trend.
Right.
You know, I don't, like, someone asked me the other day about, like, if I'm a blonde, I need to go darker in the winter, or I can't be that blonde. I'm like, that's not true.
Right.
People that have dark hair don't automatically go blonde in the summer just because it's the summer.
Right.
So you should just stay.
Girl, what happened to
right?
You?
Like, I think you should just stay with what's natural to you and then tweak it a little bit. Like, maybe tone it a little bit different or add in a low light to help change it up a little bit, but nothing so permanent.
Dark to
blonde. Like, so, yeah, you should stay true to yourself.
And for the salon here, what are some of the, I guess, not necessarily products that you carry, some of the, like, the vision of the salon and just, you know, because a lot of people will see some place like this and they'll think, oh my God, this is out of my realm, it's too Tony, they're too exclusive, or whatever, but really, it's not.
I think the sort of, like, the exclusivity is in the, like, curation of the product lines that we carry.
Okay.
That's the only, like, exclusivity I would say, because everything else feels like a family, like,
right,
when you come in. But, like, we have, like, Lenore Grell from Paris. We're the only salon, to my knowledge, in Illinois that has it.
Okay.
It's
What's
still
it
a
called?
Lenore Grell.
Okay.
It's still a family-owned product line.
Wow.
Out of Paris. And then we carry the whole line of Fido, which are all still sulfite and paraffin-free, good for the hair.
They're relaxed.
And then, like, the headband you're wearing now is from Jennifer Beer from New York. They're all handmade, and they're all handmade in New York, and we're, to my knowledge, the only one that carries it in Chicago as well.
Wow, that's awesome.
Her line.
Yeah.
They're hot. They fly off the shelf.
Oh, tell us about when you you met a certain Editrix.
An infamous person.
Yeah. You want to tell us?
How did
about
you know that?
That?
Because I post that picture. Yeah.
You did.
That was, like, the highlight of my life thus far.
What was it? What happened?
Meeting Anna Winter.
Did you? Wow.
You already knew that. You're funny.
They don't know
oh,
that.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
So,
it was actually an event for Obama. It was the Runway to Win.
Okay.
They did Runway to Win where she...
Todd, if someone wants to get in touch with you or to make an appointment here at the Anthony Cristiano Salon, how can they do that?
All the information you need is on the webpage at anthonycristiano.com. It gives all the services we provide, products that we use, everything that you need to know.
And also, are you on Twitter, Facebook? Are you on Pinterest? Where can they find you?
I'm on Twitter.
Excellent. And what is your Twitter handle?
At Todd Kempton.
Excellent. So you got that? So if you want to, again.
So I better get a million followers, like, tomorrow.
Oh, wait, you're a stalker.
I love a stalker.
So anyway, so yes, thank you so very much, Todd.
Thank you.
Thank you for allowing us to film here, and thank you for allowing us to talk to you. And we definitely think that you're someone more people ought to talk about.
Thank you.